Hello and welcome to today's vlog. Today we'll be showing the familiarization which needs to be conducted on board an LNG carrier inside the training room. Are you ready? Get set, let's go.
You've got the seat so you can take a seat and you can put the projector on and you can do a presentation. There's also TV where sometimes presentations take place there. So I'll be putting down my gimbal and we'll be reading out some items from the familiarization. Enjoy.
So I've taken my seat, the instructor is here. Usually the familiarization has to be completed within 1 week when you join the ship. So the chief officer, who's the safety officer on board for the deck department, or the second engineer, who's the safety officer for his department, will give you the familiarization. Every crew member needs to do it, even me. So you'll be handed over this booklet. It's 38 pages. This is as per SIGTTO of the International Gas Carriers, Tankers, and Oil Terminal Operators Society. So you'll be handed out the familiarization booklet. So, starting. First page, simple items like your name, your rank, and the date that you joined, and the table of contents. Contents will show you what you will have inside here, what you have to read. You may find the carriage of liquefied natural gas by sea, which says how the LNG is carried, the types of liquefied gas carriers that are available worldwide, an introduction into the physics of the LNG, cargo health and safety information, sources of ignition, and finally, you will have to read about the physics of energy. After that, we've got the alarm signals, life-saving equipment, and fire extinguishers. So the alarm signals on board are various. You have to find out which ones they are. You have to go and check on the master list, have a look on that. You must see what is your position or your duty during an actual situation or a drill. So you go and have a look on that, and then you'll come and put down, state down what type of signals we have on board and alarms. You have to know where is your life-saving appliances, where is your lifeboat, where you have to go, where you'll find the life raft, where you find the life jacket, plus the immersion suit in case you are in cold weather climate conditions. The firefighting extinguishing equipment on board, you have to know the automatic systems that you've got on board and which items can be operated from the fire stations, plus the fire extinguishers which are available on board, the types and their use. The best one for LNG fires, just remember, is dry powder. Always remember how to raise an alarm, how to bring up the attention of a fire on board a vessel. It is very important. All crew members have to know that. So let's move over to personal safety instructions. So most accidents on board happen because of carelessness. You have to be careful at all times. You have to look over after your safety. You don't want to have an accident, incident whatsoever. So before the vessel departs from port, you have to know the below items, which are very, very important. So before the vessel sails, as I said, you have to know where you have to go in case of an abandoned situation, which is your lifeboat. What are your duties during the lifeboat launching procedure? You have to check the escape routes from your cabin and workplace to lifeboat station and emergency master stations. You have to check your emergency master station. Check the emergency party duty. You have to locate the fire extinguishers on board, where they are, before the vessel sails. The nearest fire alarm near your cabin. The nearest internal telephone, which is the telephone that you can communicate internally. Where is the life jacket and the donning instructions? Where are they stored? Some vessels had them inside the cabins. Some others had life jacket boxes, most probably on the lifeboat deck. The survival suit, which is the immersion suit, this is always located inside your cabin and you have to take it with you in case of cold weather climate conditions. And where is the emergency escape breathing device? Where is that located? That's the appliance that you will wear for about 10 to 15 minutes in order to escape a fire. So when you go on board, after having a look at all of the items that I addressed before in regards to safety, life-saving, firefighting, you have to have a look on the policies of your company. Every company has their own policy, and you have to review them. So let's say our company here has the health and safety policy, has the drug and alcohol policy, the environmental and energy management policy, quality policy, security policy, social responsibility policy. So you have to review them and you have to know what is stated there. This can be found also in the booklet that they have given to you, but you can find them also in various locations on board the accommodation, so you can have a look on them at any time. Another very important thing inside this booklet familiarization is that you have the actions that you need to take when you discover a fire, when you need to abandon a ship, or you have a man overboard, and of course you have when you have to do your drills at sea, you have to read out what to do. So it's very helpful. Everybody who joins on board has to review them in order to familiarize himself with the procedures. So moving next, personal protective equipment, PPE and clothing. So remember, on board the vessels, every company has their own PPE table matrix. So you have to review it and you have to comply. Inside the accommodation, most common clothing can be worn. You can wear your own clothing that you bring from home. But outside the accommodation, you have to wear strictly your PPE. Safety comes first. It's very important that you wear your helmet, your goggles, your gloves, your boiler suit, and your safety shoes, and comply with the table, the PPE table matrix, in case you're performing a task which requires something more specific. Let's say you're going to enter inside the engine room, so you'll need to wear earmuffs. Or you're going to work aloft, you will need a safety harness. So there are many items that you will need to pay attention to. For the end, I've left down the further useful reading materials, which are quite a big number. All items can be found on board. The vessel has a library, which is on the bridge. This can be easily accessed, and you can go and borrow a book in order to read. I fully support reading. It's a very good example that an officer, a young officer, when he joins on board, is to borrow a book from the bridge, but remember to bring it back in a good condition, and he will just read items that are very, very important. I can recall my first contract on the first vessel, the company which I worked on, the first LNG vessel. I had borrowed most of the library, and I had my 6.5 months contract, I managed to read a big number of books. So remember, reading is very, very important. You have to help yourself in regards to knowledge, in regards to the physics of LNG and the operations of an LNG vessel. There are very, many, many books out there, big variety. My mind comes up to Witherby's, the standard LNG operation knowledge books. They're very, very good and will help you out if you want to help yourself understand what's going on with the LNG carrier. But in case you don't want to read these books, you can go on the cargo operation manuals that the vessel has, the SOLAS manuals, of course, which are located on board, bridge operating manual, and read out what they state down, and that will help you too. So whatever you do, I hope you read, and I wish you a very good and safe career. So that's all from me. Thank you very much for watching today, and we'll see you next week. Till then, cheerio, bye-bye.